Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to find out how to create an FAQ interaction. Here's what an interactive FAQ looks like when it's completed. It contains a list of questions that pop up with full answers when you click on them. Now let's see how to make it. You can put an FAQ right inside a PowerPoint-based course by inserting a new slide and then clicking the Interaction button. Or you can open iSpring Visuals right here from the iSpring Suite Quick Start window and choose the FAQ interaction. Up here you can add an intro, a summary, and new question items. You can change the FAQ title and the question title here, plus add all kinds of rich media. You can record or import audio, and insert pictures, videos, and flash movies. Type as many sections of text as you like right here, and use the formatting tools to fine-tune them. Plus, you can even add hyperlinks. Let's see what that completed FAQ looks like. Here's our FAQ again. I've got a simple intro, but once we get into the questions, you can see that I've enhanced the answers with program screenshots to make them more clear and simple. Don't forget, you can also add audio and video if you like. If you right-click an item in the list, you can preview it, add a new one, duplicate it, or delete it. Now let's check out the properties. Here you can enable users to search the FAQ to find what they're looking for. You can change fonts for titles and content here, and customize your player here. This works like any other iSpring color customizer. You've got a list of presets, or you can pick out each color yourself and drag them around. Now let's get out of these windows, and when you're ready to check out how it looks, just click the preview button. But you've already seen how that looks at the beginning of the tutorial, so let's go ahead and publish. Change the title and destination if you like, then pick a format, and click publish. Here you can check out how your FAQ looks on different devices, plus attach it to an email, or upload it to your website via FTP. Don't forget, you can use this directory separately or as part of a PowerPoint-based course. Thanks for watching. Now you know how to make an interactive online FAQ.
Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.